come and he'll go back to the class. And like this, this teacher by name Mrs. Thompson entered the class for the first time. And she had this habit of starting her class by saying, "Love you all." But she knew she was lying, because she could not feel that love for one of the students in the class who was very unkept, untidy. And there was nothing in the child that drew attention from Mrs. Thompson. She was little indifferent to the child. She picked him for every negative example and ignored him for all the positive reasons. That year, she had written the progress report for the first quarter. And it was a system in the school that the headmistress had to countersign every progress report. The headmistress called for Mrs. Thompson and told Mrs. Thompson, "A progress report should report some progress. It should make a parent feel my child has a future. The way you've written the progress report for Teddy," that is how he was called. "The way you've written the progress report for Teddy, parents will give up on Teddy." Mrs. Thompson immediately said, "There's nothing I can do. I have nothing positive to write about the child." Immediately, the headmistress asked the administrative staff of the school to trace the old year progress reports of Teddy and send it across to Mrs. Thompson's class. Mrs. Thompson saw the third standard progress report, and it was written, the final remarks, "Teddy is the brightest child in the class." She was stunned by what she read. She saw the fourth standard progress report, and progressively all the remarks suggested that Teddy's mother was suffering from terminal cancer. She is not able to give the attention she used to give to Teddy, and it's just beginning to show up on the performance of Teddy. The fifth standard progress report read, "Teddy had lost his mother and along with that himself. He desperately needs help, otherwise we will lose this child." By then there were tears in the eyes of Mrs. Thompson. She looked at the principal and said, "I know what to do." And she went back to the class. Probably it was a Monday morning. She walked into the class and again from the dais of the class, looked at the class and said, "Love you all." But she knew she was lying. The love she was feeling for Teddy right now was far, far greater than the rest of the class. She decided that she is going to change her approach. For every positive reason, Teddy's name was called. There was no more a negative reference to the whole thing. The last day of the school came. All the children had brought some gifts for the teacher. There was only one gift which was wrapped up in an old newspaper. Somehow, the sense of a teacher, she could knew that it must be from Teddy. She opened that first, a half-used perfume bottle and a bracelet from which a few stones had already fallen was there. The whole class laughed, knowing it was from Teddy. But without saying anything, Mrs. Thompson just took that half-used perfume bottle, sprayed it on her, wore that bracelet. With a quarter smile, it seems Teddy told, "Now you're smelling like my mother." This is the last perfume that she used before she left me. And this is what was removed from her body before she was taken into the coffin. 1 year later, end of the school, end of the year, there was a letter on Mrs. Thompson's table. "I've seen few more teachers, but you're still the best teacher I've ever seen. With love, Teddy." Every year till the end of the year, Mrs. Thompson used to get this letter from Teddy. "I've seen few more teachers, but you're the best teacher I've ever seen, Teddy." Years rolled by, they lost contact. Somewhere an agent traced Mrs. Thompson, who had retired by now, and handed over a letter. And the letter was signed, "Dr. Theodore, PhD. Teddy had gone on to become a PhD. And the letter read, "I've seen many more people in life, Mrs. Thompson. This is your Teddy. You are still the best teacher I've ever seen." I'm getting married, and I cannot dream of getting married without your presence, along with an enclosed where to and fro flight tickets. Mrs. Thompson couldn't resist. She no more had the perfume bottle, but she still preserved the bracelet. She wore that and went to the church. She was trying to sit in the last row, but volunteers identified and ushered her right to the front row. And right in the front row, there was a seat with a placard written, "Mother." Theodore personally asked Mrs. Thompson to sit in the chair and whispered, "You are the closest to my mother that I've ever experienced. And whatever I am today, it's because of you, ma'am." The wedding happened, and after the wedding, Theodore introduced Mrs. Thompson to his newly wedded wife. "Without her, I wouldn't be where I am today." There were tears in Theodore's eyes. "It seems," Mrs. Thompson told the newly wedded woman, "without Teddy, I would have never realized a teacher must first be a mother to every student of hers, and only then a teacher." This is just my request to all of you. There is a Teddy sitting in your class. When you go back to your classroom on Monday morning, there is a Teddy in the class, and you can be that Mrs. Thompson. Please, on Monday, don't go back to the institutes as a teacher. Go back as a parent who can also be a teacher and be a turning point in the life of those children. You plus me, I believe we can build a new world.
Did anybody see this video? What did you understand after this? Ma'am, understood? This has an answer for your query, right? So we don't have to deal a child as a teacher. We have to deal it as mother. तो अब उनके घर में क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हो रही है उससे भी डील करना होगा. इंटरफियर नहीं करना है, डील करना है, राइट? तो वेल, अ चाइल्ड इज इन अ प्ले ग्रुप ऑलवेज फाइंड्स हिज मदर इन अ टीचर. तो अब हमें टीचर बन के नहीं पढ़ाना है, हमें मदर बन के, बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म देम एज अ बेस्ट ह्यूमन बींग. वी आर कन्वर्टिंग देम इनटू अ बेस्ट ह्यूमन बींग. डू यू ऑल रिमेंबर कि आपको हाई स्कूल या कॉलेज में कोई ऐसा इंसिडेंट कुछ याद होगा आपको, या प्ले ग्रुप का याद रहता है? क्यों हमें हम प्ले ग्रुप और किंडरगार्टन की चीज़ें ज़्यादा याद रहती कि वो टीचर ने हमें एक रोज़ दिया था या हमें एक स्माइली दिया था? वाई आर वी दैट मच अटैच्ड टू किंडरगार्टन टीचर नॉट विद अ डिग्री टीचर? डिग्री टीचर तो शायद हमें डिग्री दे रही है, बहुत अच्छा पढ़ा रही है, हमें एक बहुत अच्छा कामयाब इंसान बना रही है, राइट? तो वाई वी डोंट रिमेंबर देम, देयर जेस्चर्स, एंड लाइक दैट वी रिमेंबर किंडरगार्टन टीचर्स? वाई इज इट सो? एग्जैक्टली. वॉट हैपन्स कि जो 1 to 6 ईयर्स का एज होता है, दैट मेक्स क्रिएट सो मैनी सिनॉप्सिस, पिक्चर्स बनाता है अपने सबकॉन्शियस माइंड में. वो सिनॉप्सिस कैसे बनते हैं? जब हमारा एक रिलेशन बनता है, एक कनेक्शन बनता है बच्चे के साथ, तो वो बहुत जल्दी इमोशनली अटैच्ड हो जाते हैं, जो हम कॉलेज डेज में नहीं होते, क्योंकि हमें इन मटीरियल चीज़ें हो रही, इमोशन हमारे इधर से 10% हो जाता है, 90% वी आर फोकस्ड. हमारा एम क्या होता है हमारे लाइफ में? हमारा अचीवमेंट होता है हमारा डिग्री, हमारा मास्टर्स, देन अ जॉब, देन अ वेल पेड जॉब, एंड देन फैमिली, देन फैमिली हॉलीडेज. तो ये सारी क्या चीज़ें हैं? वॉट आर दिस थिंग्स? हमारे अपने उस पर सिर्फ पर्सनैलिटी को ग्रो करने की चीज़ें हैं. वी आर नॉट गिविंग समथिंग टू एनी बडी, वी आर पजेसिंग एवरीथिंग. ये दिस इज कॉल्ड अ परसेप्शन. अ परसेप्शन चेंजेस व्हेन यू ग्रो. Since till the age of 1 to 6 years, you are very much attached. You know the feeling. You know the touch and feel. You know what does the person mean for you. Because you are dependent. Aap kahin na kahin dependent hai. At that time, aap dependent nahin hai. Even to these days, college mein shayad koi lecture hota nahin hai. Bacche aise hi ghar pe hi apna self-study karke, they go and give their exam and they get their degree. So they lose the interest or the importance of a teacher. And children, they are very much dependent on you. And that dependency you have to encash. ये सारा कुछ हमें encash करना है. अभी वो लोग emotionally हमारे अंदर हैं और we have to encash those quality and groom them. तो वो grooming का वो process जो होता है वो 1 to 6 years में सबसे maximum होता है. क्योंकि उनके back of the mind में career नहीं होता, उनके back of the mind में highest pay नहीं होती, उनके back of the mind में marriage और holidays नहीं होती. Right. उनके पास बस ये होता है कि मैं और मेरी क्लासरूम, मेरे फ्रेंड्स, मेरी टीचर, मेरी मम्मा, मेरी फैमिली, राइट. और जो उस टाइम पे वो करेंगे, आपको मैंने ये जो एक छोटा सा वो दिया, एक्टिविटी दी कि आपको अपने नाम के साथ एक ऑब्जेक्टिव अटैच करना है, क्यों इंस्टेंटली आपको नहीं आया? व्हाई वाज इट दैट इंस्टेंटली आपको कुछ अपने लिए क्यों नहीं समझ में आया कि मेरे पास इतनी अच्छी क्वालिटी, आई हैव ब्यूटिफुल फेस, आई हैव अ गुड हाइट और मे बी अ वेरी स्मार्ट लुकिंग ह्यूमन बीइंग आई एम. व्हाई डोंट यू थिंक फॉर योरसेल्फ? इन योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड, राइट. दैट इज द डिफरेंस. So we can always mold a child when he is in the growing age. और growing age में ही हम बहुत कुछ सिखा सकते हैं. और वो सिखाने का तरीका आज कल थोड़ा सा change हो गया, that is doing and learning. मतलब वो वाला that is old practices, when traditional practice you can say that the teacher was doing and children were just ideally sitting and observing the teacher. Like teacher used to